Second opinion. The Shudras did not have the right to acquire the knowledge. Like study the Veda, they did not undergo the Abhinav Sanskara and they did not have the right to participate in Yajna and other religious activities, rituals. According to my third view, the Shudras had the right to acquire the Brahma Vidya only. The proponents of this view say that there are references to the fact that Shudra had the right to acquire the Brahma Vidya. All the women have the right to Brahma Vidya in Vedanta, and the gods also have the right, that right. When all the men have that right, then the Shudra also have it, Vigraha, accepting the offering, consuming them, being satiated and giving bone to the Yajaman after feeling happy. These five are proper for the consciousness known to Shabdatmak gods. This proves that when the gods are entitled to Vigraha, they are also entitled to Brahma Vidya. This is an consciousness with the scripture which propound the karma mukti. A person reaches the Brahma Lok through the agraha, upasana, acquires divine body and enjoys the divine pleasure. By the strength of the sanskara, he would obtain the Brahma Gyan and attain the salvation through the self-realization. This is karma mukti. That is why even the gods being considered as human worthy of Brahma Vidya is unconscious with the Shrutis. Just as an tad yato yo devana. Entitlement to Brahma Vidya is given not only to the human but also to gods. Similarly in Shrutis, the Shudras are also entitled to the same rights as the witch. As the gods have the right to Brahma Vidya, so have the Shudras. For example, Vidur etc. My friend already explained that thing. Vidur is belong to Shudra. And although I have objection, because there is no evidence to show that Vidur is the Shudra, because Vidur born by Brahman father and Shudra mother, and that is the called separate caste, not the child known by the father name. Beyond this my topic, I also want to say that if we go through the Brahmanical system, or if you go through the Varna Vyavastha, then there is a positive one thing important is that if the Brahman Brahman woman and lower caste Shudra man, they marry to each other and they create the child, that is called another caste. That is the positive, I can say. Because in modern scenario, if anybody remain the caste, inter-caste marriage, then the child should be called by father caste, not by mother or not by another caste. That is the separate thing. Come to the main point. So, Shudra to have the right to acquire the knowledge, like Vidur. Chandogya Upanishad describes an incident that King Janasruti offered 600 cows and charities, etc. to Guru Rikab and prayed that he be surmised in the Samgraha Vidya. He told, Aha Haritva Shudra Tadev Sahabhagu Vyastu. Thus, Rikal used the word Shudra for Janasruti and refused to give the sermon. Then, the king offered him his daughter and lots of wealth. This made Rikal Rishi happy and he gave the sermon on Samgraha Vidya to Janasruti. That point to be noted. Thus, when the Shudra had the right to acquire the Samgraha Vidya, there was no question of them not having the right to Shudra to the Brahman Vidya, Brahma Vidya. As a Shudra is imparting the Samgraha Vidya, so he is entitled to it. But he does not have the right to acquire all the Vidyas. He is not entitled to participating and conducting the rituals involving the fire. But they are not barred from acquiring the Brahma Vidya. Hence, Shudra should be considered entitled to Brahma Vidya. The Brahma Sutra says that all the Vidyas are entitled to Brahma Vidya. Like commentary says that all are entitled to Vedaham. The Upanayana is not in need to for acquiring Brahma Vidya. For example, the king Ashwapati has had imparted knowledge through sermon of six rishis without them having undergone the Upanayana Sanskara. This proves that one has the right to acquire the knowledge without Upanayana Sanskara. Thus, Shudra can also have the right to acquire Brahma Vidya without Upanayana Sanskara. To prove this point, commentator dwells on the types of Upanayana Sanskara. It is two types. One is the Upavit performed through the proper procedure of the study of Vedas. And the second one is the Upasadhan. Upasadhan forever. Thank you. The second is the Upasadhan. Second is the Upasadhan for acquiring the Brahma Vidya. Upasadhan is also of two types. The first is student going to the teacher, and the second is the teacher accepting him as a disciple and keeping him in his company for a long period and allowing the disciple to serve him. Then he can acquire the knowledge in the company of this the teacher. That is the condition of acquiring the knowledge, dear my friend.
1 minute left.
Then he can acquire the knowledge in the company of a teacher, because acquiring the knowledge is the right of all the things, and every person should be given adequate opportunity for acquiring the knowledge. Thus, whoever wants to hear sermon on the Brahma Vidya can do so. There is no spiritual hurdles in this. Before imparting the knowledge, a person suitable is regarded first by a sanskara, and is there absence with what a person says. This means that without sanskara also a person can be imparted the knowledge and he can gain the knowledge. Rekha Rishi gave sermon to the Janasruti as he did not have any fault. The scripture prescribed that when a student goes to the teacher for acquiring the knowledge, he gauges his suitability and then perform the opinion sanskara. Clearly, then when there are no student worthy of gaining the knowledge, opinion is not indicated. Prashno Upanishad in the beginning described the Sukhdev, Bhagwaj, etc. six persons in the quest of the knowledge reached the Piplad Rishi to know about the Brahma Vidya. They all were the knowledge and had the complete faith in Brahma. This scholarship was evident by the question which they asked the Piplad Rishi one by one. In this, there is no mention of their Upanishad Sanskara. Similarly, according to the Chandogya Upanishad, the Narad had learned Brahma Vidya from Sanat Kumara Rishi. Here also there is no mention of Upanishad Sanskara. The same Upanishad say that in the ancient time, five Christian men who were very rich and strong Vedas for acquiring the Brahma Vidya. He sends him to the Ashwapati, the king of Kekai, who gives the sermon to them. Analyzes the curiosity about the Brahma is also the right of human to study and hear the scripture. The use of word human indicates that Shudraj also had the right to acquire the Brahma Vidya. I conclude my paper on that. The caste-based structure have formed the basis of the analysis of Indian society. And these structures are said to have emanated from the Varna Vyavastha. It is generally believed that overall there have been very few changes in the Indian society based on Varna system. It is in the context of the changes that the right of Shudras to acquire the knowledge has been analyzed here. We find two references in the classical tradition. There are the references to Shudra being barred from acquiring the knowledge, which is evident in the Veda and Vedic Sanhita. There are some rishis who were Shudras, but here is also there is a difference of opinion on whether they were Shudras or not. At the same time, in Upanishad, we find the references of Brahma Vidya being acquired without Upanishad Sanskara. The Shudra were given the right to acquire Sangraha Vidya only. It is clearly that Shudras more or less had the right to acquire the Brahma Vidya. However, subsequently, an interest took over, and this interest is very visible in the post-Vedanta literature. Thank you so much for having me.
I'm sure there are questions and discussion. We have just 5 minutes.
How is the practice today in India? Can a Shudra acquire knowledge? Can anybody acquire this knowledge? How is the practice today? Today.
If I tell about the tourism, because now it is an independent country and India has a constitution.
Sure.
So there are many rights to protect the present scenario, or to protect the caste system, or to protect the shadow caste person, that I have already mentioned in Shudra development based of SCST and OBC. But now, because we have a right in our constitution, that there is no problem. There are some aspects in practical our life, and there are lots of problems inside. Although there are lots of problems, but we have a right to acquire the knowledge, to gain anything from our country, whether it is business, whether it is industry, whether it is film media, whether it is the job, and whether it is the privatization. Thank you. Yes.
Maharshi Dayananda Saraswati is a proponent of the Shudra as to become Brahmins.
Really, sir? I am already, today, you are saying.
The Arya Samajis are now practicing their works, and they are eager to make Brahmins or make Hindus. Who is eager to be Hindu. If a non-Hindu can become a Hindu, and any there is a Apastambadhara, he provides a sloka of Apastambadhara Sutra, where there is it is karman. Uttam karma, द्वारा मतलब बिकाउज ऑफ उत्तम कर्म अब जघन्यो वर्ण उत्तमम वर्णम प्राप्ति अथवा उत्तम वर्ण जघन्य हीन कर्म द्वारा जघन्य वर्ण प्राप्ति इति नियम तत्र अपस्तम्भ धर्म सूत्र द्वारा विहितम अस्ति.
थैंक यू.
थैंक यू सर. इज इट क्वेश्चन और
talked about Vidur and his birth, so I would like to talk about Vyasa's birth, his father and mother, and I want you to comment on the status of Vyas in Rishis, whether he was respected or not, because his mother was also not a Brahmin. Yeah, Vidur's mother was not Brahmin.
Born by unmarried.
And Vidur was also a very respected person. He was very respected person, respected by Pandavas, respected by Kauravas. He was addressed by them as uncle. Yeah, even today he is respected because of his deeds, not because of his caste. Though his mother was not a Brahmin, certainly you said. So similarly, I want to talk about Vyasa's birth, whose again mother was not a Brahmin, and who is also considered to be in a way Niyog was there. So he was these Pandavas and Kauravas were his progenies. So can you tell me about Vyasa's status and his respect?
You have already answered, no?
Yeah.
I think so.
But the question is, you were saying.
I'm not saying anything. That kind of people do not apply the respect of. We respect all the inter relation inter new born caste. I think so. And I have gave the example of Vidur, and you are saying about the Vyas. Actually, there is no the question of regarding anybody. You are getting my point, I think so.
Yes.
I have just analyzed the historical background. If we get the new caste, or if we get the new varna, then that is maybe he create a new caste, and we are creating the caste, subcaste, and again subcaste. That is only my submission. And that is most important thing in history. We found the Brahmin Purush, Brahmin man, and Shudra woman. They they make the relation, and they caste. They another caste form the another caste.
We have a 20-second question.
Yes, thank you.
of the Shraddha sacrifices. I guess I just wonder, how early in the Vedic corpus do we get references to the Upanayana ceremony?
Well, actually, the Upanayana condition is that if anybody belong to Brahmana, Kshatriya and Vaishya, there are no provision of Shudras for Upanayana. But when we find the references of Brahmasutra Shankara Bhashya or something, I have already explained some Upanishads. They give the right to acquire the knowledge of only Brahma Vidya or Sampada Samahan, or I have mentioned the Sangraha Vidya. Mm-hmm. That is the little bit difference between the Upanayana Sanskara condition of it to acquire the knowledge or to acquire the Vidya. And Brahma Vidya is the different. There is a slightly difference between both conditions. I think you are getting
it. I should stop there to get rid of
all. Thank you so much.